What's up, YouTube? Today we're hiking into the woods and we're cooking a traditional Hawaiian dish on the riverbank. So that right here is the ho'io, pohole, warabi, fern shoot. So we're gonna take some of these. I'm gonna use them as a garnish. And also they just taste good. I'm gonna fry them up with the akule. So since we got it around us, we'll utilize a little bit. So in the back of this forest is a lot of different kinds of ginger flowers, or in Hawaiian, it's called avapuhi. These ones are like a red ginger flower, if I'm not mistaken. If you guys know too, let me know like exactly what it's called, because I would love to know. I'm still learning too, you know. There's more of these little red shampoo ginger ones, or avapuhi. And let's grab it. Yeah, these are so good. Like my favorite little snacks out here. But this place is really sick. If you look up over here, you got a huge kukui nut tree. We got a mountain apple tree. Over there is a coconut tree. A lot of cool stuff growing back here. And everywhere around us is a lot of that ho'io fern shoot, the pohole. So there's an avocado tree right over there. Like that one up to the right, the light green leaves right there. It's pretty sick. Oh, dude, coconut tree. Let's see if we can score ourselves a coconut. I would love that right now. I'm pretty thirsty. If you can see the clarity of this stream, this is like not good for drinking. Like when you see the cloudiness, and it's either been raining upstream or like some kind of like mud slided into the stream or something, but not good for drinking. Oh, dude, check this out, blue ginger over here. So right here is a blue ginger, purple ginger. People call it all different types of names, but this one is non-edible. So I highly suggest not trying to eat that, because it'll make your mouth numb and like all weird, but it's a really beautiful plant and it has a nice smell. And as we go up more, I can already see heliconia. I can already see some of the torch gingers over here to the left. This place just is like, is crazy with flowers right now. It's kind of like the ginger flower season summer. It's late spring and then all throughout summer. So a good way of like foraging, if you really don't have any skills with it, you can't know how to identify stuff. If you see rotten fruit on the forest floor like that, just look straight up, and 9 out of 10 times, you'll be sitting right underneath the tree that it is. Like this is a mountain apple tree, but it's covered in vines and looks like it fruited way long ago, but still good to know while you're out here. There's none on the tree right now, but you can see the pits in the water too. If you look and you see avocado pits or mountain apple pits, you're probably standing directly under one of their trees. Albizia is a invasive wood that really took over a lot of parts of the islands and stuff. People are using it to make cutting boards. They're utilizing it in all kinds of cool ways right now. And it's interesting to see. This one falls really easy. If you look up there, we're sitting like right underneath a huge canopy of them. My favorite part about albizia is the branches when they fall. They're usually the ones that contain woodier mushrooms and the other kinds of mushrooms that I like. And let's go look for a coconut. I already see a huge monster coconut right here. This thing looks nuts. So there's a monster, right here is a ulu tree. This is a breadfruit tree, but it's not fruiting right now. It's kind of standing right in the middle of this stream, which is pretty cool. And then if I look right here, I can already see 4 or 5 coconuts. These look already rotten, but I want to just show you the size of these guys. It's pretty nuts. That's a big one. Yeah, I think this is already tunched. If you look up there, there's big ones. You gotta be probably kind of careful to not have one of these fall on your head. They're so big and so high up. That's like a death zone if you get cracked in the head by one of those things. Let's go see if we can score one. I really want a coconut right now. Always make sure your footings are secure. I'm not even gonna try that. I think it's so rotten. There's been times I've been hiking alone and stepping on stuff like this. One time I fell like 20 feet into a riverbed because I was like walking over one of these by myself. Thank God I landed good and I didn't get that damaged from it. I like hurt my wrist, but I was really far up in a stream and had no way of someone knowing besides that I told some people I was gonna go hiking. So I'm a lot more careful now because of that experience. And right here, this is cool. This is a baby, ulu tree. And this is awesome. Hopefully in a couple years, this guy will be producing. So right here is a baby sprouted coconut. And if you look there, there's 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is gonna be a coconut patch pretty soon, all because of this one coconut tree, dude. That's awesome. But the likelihood of these surviving with all this other brush on top of it, I mean, with the amount of water, I could see it happening, but who knows? But I do know that when they're sprouted like this, 9 out of 10 times they're filled up with creamy white meat. So I'm gonna take one of these sprouted coconuts and see if we can get some food out of it. So when they're sprouted like this, they got roots already. And these roots are really strong. Actually, let me just see something real quick. See what it looks like on the middle before I go fully into it. Oh yeah, this is gonna be really good. Here we go. All right, I gotta get this guy out then. There we go. So that's our sprouted coconut. Cool. You see right here where I checked? That's the meat right there. So this thing is probably filled up with the white sprouted meat, which is like basically like coconut cream. And this is the price we pay when we come out here. These little fuckers. Look at this hair. This is the stuff that's gonna make our fire just like take off. Honestly, I think I could use the flint on this stuff. Okay, so now we got our little coconut bro taken out right here. And I'm really curious on seeing how far along he is. So I'm gonna show you how to open one of these. I use the dull end of this. And I just kind of crack it like that. Oh, yup. And that's the sprouted coconut. So all this meat right here, super creamy. This is still really good too, but I want to try a little piece of this. That's so sweet. It's like, look at that. That's a sprouted coconut. It's got all that coconut water turned into like this like creamy like foam. It's so good. You can see the coconut oil on the outside right here too. That's all coconut oil. Yeah, so the meat kind of lost a lot of its flavor because all of that meat kind of like just like went turned into this thing. You can just grind that. So good. It's like that coconut ice cream basically. So this is our dessert for today. It's like, I don't know how to explain it. It's like coconut cream mousse or foam, and it's just like sugary, coconut watery, creamy flavor. Yum. And then all this is super good for oil. So I'm gonna take all this meat out. I'm gonna scrape the inside of this and get all this coconut oil off. And then I'll see if we can fry our akule in the coconut oil from this sprouted coconut. So let's get to it. Today I'm using a little, kind of like a barbecue starter for charcoal, but I'm gonna throw this coconut fiber from our sprouted coconut in here. And then I brought also a little bit of kiawe wood because it burns really hot and that's what I kind of need. If you look over there, all this wood is really damp and moist. I could make it work for sure, but today I want to just kind of focus more on the cooking instead of the survival aspect. And in other videos, I will get in depth on like just using flints and all that kind of stuff. Even right now, I want to try to use a flint just to see. But if I get frustrated, I'm just going to use a lighter, so just heads up. It's not our day. Just look at how easy this is. Ah, fuck. Okay. So remember our sprouted coconut? Well, this meat is just basically pure coconut oil, kind of fat. We're gonna scrape it out and then we're gonna throw it in here, render it in the pan, and then we're gonna fry our akule in it. Cut some of this coconut meat out. The fat that's like right here, this is all coconut oil. Not the meat itself, but just this like little layer that's like cold coconut milk, I mean coconut oil basically. Or what do you call it here? See how it's like wet like that? That's the fat coming out of it. This really wouldn't work with if it wasn't sprouted. So what happened is all the sugars in the water went into this piece right here. And the coconut oil and fat is feeding it from the outside. Like all this is fat. So I'm gonna scrape this stuff off. This is all coconut oil. Save this on the side for later, for dessert. And then all that right there, that's perfect. Fresh coconut oil. So before I use a leaf, I'm gonna wash it in the river. Get it all clean. There we go. This is gonna be my little plate slash cutting board. So this is an akule fish, Hawaiian big eye scad. It's similar to like a, kind of like a sardine, a little bit oily. It's like really good. It's like mackerel kind of. And look at that meat right there. So this is our little guy for today. Put him down. So we got our tide pool salt that we got. It's our salt for today. Forage that too. Got a little bit of olive oil just for flavor and to get this guy so he doesn't stick to the pan too hard. So we're making like a traditional Hawaiian meal, something that they used to eat back in the day, which is kalo from my friend's lo'i. And that's like a kalo farm, basically Hawaiian taro. So it's real simple today, just a little bit of a spiced akule and some kalo roasted up in the pan with some of that coconut oil we found in the sprouted coconut oil. I mean, the sprouted coconut earlier. So cool, we got our fish spiced. We got our fire right here going.
Just put a little salt on him, some of that tide pool salt. Okay, so we're gonna put our guy down, or smoke the Akule. Put him in that coconut oil, from the sprouted coconut. I'm gonna use that same leaf as like my my grill thing, and then let that guy sit. Perfect. So this is Kalo. So I pre-cooked this at home. This is fresh from my friend's lo'i yesterday. He gave me a nice big korm of it. And this kind of stuff, you gotta cook it all the way through before you eat it, because it does have calcium oxide, which will tighten up your throat, like I explained in that luau leaf video. And so I cooked it through. This is the purple variety, and it's really good. So we're gonna add it in here. Just a couple chunks. I want to crisp it up. I love my kalo nice and crispy when I eat it in this way. Oh, throw a couple chunks in there and get it seared off on one side. This stuff is like so tasty and really healthy for you too. And in Hawaii, it just makes sense to eat it because it's such a good carbohydrate and just traditional to the land, and it helps everything out when you eat this. You help out the farmers who grow it in the native Hawaiian style. And the just eat this. So good. That's without salt or anything. That's just natural. But let's fry this one up. So I'm gonna go ahead and give it a little bit of that tide pool salt. Nothing fresher than fresh Hawaiian sea salt and kalo cooked in sprouted coconut oil, which is just the rendered fat of the coconut. So this is an all organic, all local meal, and I can't wait, I'm starving. This is the way I like to eat, like straight, everything local. And these are two indigenous ingredients. I know I focus a lot on the invasive stuff, but in this case, I figured I'd use two of the best local ingredients that I like to eat personally, which is kalo and akule. What's a better place to eat it than just straight out here in the jungle, you know? Just not bothering anyone, just. It's even got some of the fish flavor from when I fried the fish. The little crispy bits are so good. And like, this is how, this is like what makes sense to eat in Hawaii. Like, this is what Hawaiians used to eat mostly, was fish and kalo. That was like a big part of their diet. So I got my little ho'io. I'm gonna just kind of put them in the flames. Ho'io, my little crispy ho'io fern as my garnish. And then I got these ginger flower shoots from the avapuhi. A little more lemon. Love lemon with my fish. A little bit on the kalo. Perfect. So let's pick this guy up. Ah. Now we're ready to eat. Look at that. So I'm gonna go ahead and eat my little bounty in the middle of the stream. Whatever falls down is gonna feed these crawfish, and then next time we can do a better crawfish boil. So I'm gonna try my kalo first.
smoky, crispy, got the flavor of the coconut oil.
So I'm gonna go ahead and try a piece of the akule. Look at that crispiness, like crispy meat from the coconut oil, and then it was sitting on top of the kiawe flame for a little bit. So,
bro, that's so good. Oh shit, this is good.
Let's try like a little god bite. This is a straight god bite right here. You get a piece of your crispy kalo, put your fish on top, get your little ginger, ginger flower shoot. Look at that. Send it home with your hoyo.
Thank you guys for watching our traditional Hawaiian meal by the river. Make sure to like, subscribe, and comment below. And stay tuned for next week when we come out with our new video.